Here's today's In Touch devotion.
Today's scripture reading begins in verse 31 of Matthew chapter 25. Jesus is speaking. But when the Son of Man comes in His glory, and all the angels with Him, then He will sit on His glorious throne. All the nations will be gathered before Him, and He will separate them from one another, as the shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And He will put the sheep on His right, and the goats on the left. Then the King will say to those on His right, "Come, you who are blessed of My Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave Me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave Me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited Me in. Naked, and you clothed Me. I was sick, and you visited Me. I was in prison, and you came to Me." Then the righteous will answer Him, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? And when did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and come to you?" The King will answer and say to them, "Truly I say to you, to the extent that you did it to one of these brothers of Mine, even the least of them, you did it to Me." Then He will also say to those on His left, "Depart from Me, accursed ones, into the eternal fire which has been prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave Me nothing to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave Me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not invite Me in. Naked, and you did not clothe Me. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit Me." Then they themselves also will answer, "Lord, when did we see you hungry, or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not take care of you?" Then He will answer them, "Truly I say to you, to the extent that you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to Me." These will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life.
The scriptures speak clearly of existence after death. People will spend eternity in either heaven or hell. Yet many individuals consider this truth inconsistent with other facts about the Lord. While their objections are understandable, the Bible provides the answers. How can the Lord be good if He lets some people spend eternity in hell? God is love, and He doesn't want anyone to live without Him. According to His plan, every person who wants to can turn from sin and receive the Savior, enjoying His presence both now and throughout eternity. Some, however, reject Jesus Christ and live apart from Him all their days. Unless they change that tragic decision, their separation from divine love will continue eternally. Why would God create certain individuals knowing they'd never turn to Him? To some, this seems unloving. Yet God, who obviously knows that He gave us a will, won't force anyone to go to heaven against his or her will. Doing so would amount to creating robots who are unable to truly respond, love, and worship. And one more objection: an endless penalty seems unfair, especially if a non-Christian never heard the gospel. As long as unbelievers are alive, the Heavenly Father goes to great lengths to keep them from eternal punishment, except He won't violate their free will. He gives enough time and evidence so that nobody has a valid excuse for rejecting the one path to salvation. Jesus wants you to spend eternity with Him. So the question is, have you received His gift of forgiveness and surrendered your life to Him?